Hey guys, I'm Dave Chesson of Kindlepreneur.com, and in today's video, I want to talk to you about why I love using Scrivener over Word to write my books and what Scrivener can do to help you. Although Word can do a lot of things that you probably didn't know it could do, most authors still choose Scrivener, especially when you see them side by side, which is what I'm going to show you today. Also, if you haven't purchased Scrivener yet, go ahead and click the link in the description just below this video where I have a full Scrivener review and have a 20% off discount code that you can use to purchase it with. So be sure to check it out. And with that, let's begin. I've gone ahead and started a new document in both Scrivener and Word. As you can see, Scrivener immediately asks me what type of project I'm going to create. It lists out things like fiction, nonfiction, screenplay, and a whole lot more. Selecting one of these, Scrivener will use a template that is truly designed for those writing assignments, highlighting the most useful features for those specific projects. With Word, while it does offer templates, none of them come close to the author-centric projects like Scrivener. Now, let's look at the design and layout. Once we've opened up a project, the layout and design flow is very different between the two. One of my favorite parts of Scrivener is the binder area. This allows you to plan your book out before you even start writing by allowing you to create chapters and even add notes to each. Plus, you can also drag and drop resources into it and move chapters around, all of which makes creating a full-blown book very easy to plan and chop up into bite-sized elements. With Word, you can sort of do the same thing, just by clicking into your review tab and selecting a review pane. This will list sections of your books based on header tags that you give it. However, it's not as simple as Scrivener. For example, you can't just create a new chapter. Instead, you have to select the chapter title and make it a header 2 tag. To create a sub-chapter, you need to use a heading 3 tag, and so forth. One of the strong points for Scrivener is the ability to see your project in different ways. Up at the top, we can select between our original page layout, corkboard, and the outliner. Corkboard is very useful in planning out your project. Think of it more like your note cards in which you can set up your upcoming chapters and their scope. Outliner is one of my favorite project management views. Once you have your chapters, you can give them labels, status updates, set target word counts, and even see how you're tracking in each. It's a great way to look at your writing project as a whole and know where you need to add more work. Word doesn't exactly have this feature, and although there are other sets of software out there you could use to do this, it's very beneficial to have everything within one program. Another layout element that I love with Scrivener is the ability to see both my research and write in the same window. To do this, all you need to do is click the button here, select the window, and put whatever you want in the new window by clicking it. If you want to refer to a previous chapter, just click the chapter. If you want to refer to something you placed in research, just click it, and there you go. In Word, there is no function quite like this, and an easy way for you to get around it is to shrink your typing window and open up the file as a separate window. Not as sleek, but it does do the trick. Another thing I love about Scrivener is the inspector window. There are hundreds of little features inside this tool set that allow super advanced novelists extra capability to track their notes, footnotes, references, and more. But for me, I love that my notes from my corkboard view show up here. I use this a lot to make sure that when I'm working on a particular chapter, I stay on target. Now, let's come to the final part of our book writing process, formatting. With Scrivener, exporting as an EPUB is extremely simple. Because of its layout, Scrivener already knows what parts are the different chapters and can therefore export with a click of a button. All of the exporting capabilities and opportunities lie within Scrivener, so no need to use other programs to get your book ready for publishing, both on Amazon and other platforms like Draft2Digital and Smashwords. Let's see what this is like with Word. In order to export your book for publishing, you'll need to ensure that you have set up all the H1 tags and H2 tags prior to saving. Then, you'll need to send your Word document to a third-party software or service in order to get it turned into the appropriate file. As you can see, it's not that simple as it is with Scrivener, and I personally love knowing that I have the one software that does it all instead of having to jump from program to program in order to get my book ready. So there you have it. Word does do a lot more than people give it credit for, but once you've seen the two side by side, it's very obvious as to why all authors use Scrivener instead of Word when they want to create that momentous, giant project of a book. So, if you decide you want to use this handy-dandy writing tool for your next book project, go ahead and click the link below in the description, access my Scrivener review, and use that 20% off discount code. I'm Dave Chesson of Kindlepreneur.com, signing off. Cheers.